a component used in the Mars Pathfinder can be idealized as a circular bar clamp at its end. The bar should withstand a torque of 1000 Newton meter. The components is assembled on the Earth when the temperature is 30. The temperature on the Mars at the site of landing is minus 70. The material of the bar has an allowable shear stress of 300 megapascal and its eggs modulus is 200 gigapascal. Design the diameter of the bar taking a factor of safety of 1.5 and assuming a coefficient of thermal expansion for the material of the bar as 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree Celsius. So we have a torque of 1000, T1 equal to 30. The temperature on the Mars is given as minus 70. So delta T will be T1 minus T2. 30 minus 70, minus 70 is 100. Value of E is also given. Value of E is 200 gigapascal. The value of allowable shear stress is directly given. That is tau allowable is given. 300 megapascal. And the factor of safety is 1.5. And alpha is given as 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree Celsius.
So
since he has given this, we can calculate strain. So strain equal to change in length upon original length.
For length due to the change in length due to temperature is given by alpha times delta T
times L, correct? Divided by L. So it's simply alpha multiplied by delta T. That equal to 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 multiplied by 100. So this is 12 into 10 to the power minus 4. And we know the stress is also given by the sigma x I am writing is epsilon multiplied by E. So this is 12 into 10 to the power minus 4. And Young modulus is 200 10 to the power 3 megapascal. So this value will come to be, so the sigma x we have got 240. Torque is 10 to the power 6, pi by 6, d cube. So that will be equals to 300 divided by 1.5. 300 is allowable and we want to make a factor of safety also equals to 1.5. Just tau xy. So tau xy is 6 into 10 to the power 6 divided by pi d cube, correct? Tau xy is 16 times 10 to the power 6 pi d cube. So using this tau max, we can have a tau allowable tau is 300. So this is 300, factor of safety is 1.5 under root of sigma x is, sigma x we have found out is 240 divided by 2 is 120 square plus tau xy is 16 into 10 to the power 6 divided by pi d cube.
Now you can solve this equation
and you can obtain diameter d.
The approximate answer is 31.69 mm.
In a torsion test, the specimen is a hollow shaft with a 50 mm external and 30 mm internal diameter.
an applied torque of 1.6 Newton meter is found to produce an angular twist of 0.4, measured on a length of 0.2 meter of the shaft. The modulus of elasticity is 200 gigapascal. We need to find out the value of modulus of rigidity, that is G, and Poisson ratio. So DO is 50, DI is 30. So value of K will be DI by DO is 3 by 5 is 0.6 now. So torque is 1.6 10 to the power 6, theta is 0.4. So it will be multiplied by pi divided by 180. So that answer will be in radian. So theta is 0.0069 radian, L is 200 and E is equal to 210 to the power 3 megapascal. So let's first calculate tau. So we'll use the first term and last term, and we have T by J equals to G theta by L. So torque is 1.6 10 to the power 6. J is pi by 32. DO to the power 4 minus DI to the power 4 times G times theta 0.0069 divided by L is 200. So if you solve this, you will get value of G. All of you are getting 85.92, that is gigapascal. Next, we'll use the equation which relates between the Young modulus E and the modulus of rigidity, that is equals to twice G into 1 plus mu. We already covered this equation in chapter 1. This one is 200. This 2 times 85.92. 1 plus mu. So mu come out to be 0.164. We have a cantilever tube of length 120 mm is subject to an axial tension of 9 kilonewton, a torsional moment of 72 and a bending load of 1.75 kilonewton at the free end. The material is an aluminium alloy with an yield strength, that is E given as 276. You want to find out the thickness of the tube limiting the outside diameter to be 50 mm so as to ensure a factor of safety equals to 4. Outside diameter is given. You want to calculate thickness. It means that indirectly you want to calculate what? Internal diameter. You want to find out thickness of the tube. External diameter is given to you. So you have to indirectly you want to calculate what? DI. And once you get DI, you are able to calculate thickness. The section is hollow or section is solid? Hollow section. Now as far as SMD and BMD is concerned, we can only construct the SMD BMD for transverse loading. The length of this one is given as 120. Outside diameter is given as 50. As far as the cantilever is concerned, is the bending moment will be a line. Shear force diagram will be constant. If the shear force diagram is rectangle, then is the bending moment is a triangle. And the area of this triangle, is it equals to the maximum value of bending moment at fixed end.
So this actually FL. So how much is this value? Minus FL is 1.75 multiplied by 120.
So maximum bending moment is FL, and that equals to F is 1750 multiplied by 120 is the total bending moment is 2.1 10 to the power 5. Will it produce the bending stress?
So bending stress for this one is given by sigma b equals to so bending moment is 2.1 10 to the power 5 pi by 64 into 50 to the power 4 minus di to the power 4 is equal to sigma b multiplied by 25. So what is sigma b?
So sigma bending is obtained as 1.069 10 to the power 8 divided by 50 to the power 4 minus di to the power 4. Now we'll handle this time the torsion, and then we'll finally handle the axial pull, that equals to 9 kilonewton. So if the torque is 72 into 10 to the power 3 newton mm, then so we have T by J equal to tau divided by rho. So T is 72 10 to the power 3, J is pi by 32, DO is 50 to the power 4 minus DI to the power 4, this is tau xy, RO is 25, so tau xy is 18.33 10 to the power 6, 50 to the power 4 minus DI to the power 4. And now finally we'll consider axial pull. Apply the pull of 9 kilonewton over this tube. Is the all the members are subjected to tensile stress? So that stress is directly the P upon area. And is that area is pi by 4 DO square minus DI square. So sigma axial is P. P is given as 9000 divided by area is pi by 4. DO square. DO square is known to us, 50 square. Minus DI square. So sigma actually is 11.46 10 to the power 3 divided by 50 to the power 4 minus DI square. Now the problem is not here. The problem. So one point we consider here on the top side. Here. And one point we'll consider here on the bottom side. So which has a chance of failure? Forget about tau, because tau is same for both, because they are on the outer fiber. What about the bending? How the bending will occur for this? Will the bending will occur like this? Correct? And if the bending will occur like this, so is the B will be in compression and A will be in what? Tension. Now B is compression, it means that the bending stress for this one, that is equation given by equation number 1, is negative value. Negative value. Whereas sigma axial is a positive value. So net value for B, is it less? Correct? For B, your sigma bending is negative and sigma axial is positive. Whereas point A, both are positive. It means that the sigma x produced at point A is more as compared to B. So B, point A is more critical as compared to the point B. So failure will be considered at point A and not at B. Shear stress remains same. So our state of stress can be represented like this. So this is a state of stress for point A. And this one is sigma B. Plus sigma axial, and this one is tau xy. So we can very well compute sigma max using this equation, and the allowable value of sigma max is SYT by FOS. SYT is given to you. 276. Factor of safety is 4. Sigma y is 0. Sigma b plus sigma a will replace sigma x. This total is replaced as sigma x. Value of sigma y is 0. Tau xy is known. You have to substitute all those things here. And then you have to solve for dy. If you substitute for everything for sigma x, sigma tau xy and sigma y, then approximate answer is 45 mm. We are given a hollow shaft of diameter ratio 3/8 required to transmit 600 kilowatts at 110 rpm. The maximum torque being 20% greater than the mean torque. The torque you are using in the equation of 600 kilowatt, that is power equal to 2 pi n t by 60. Whenever the formula is of physics, the torque is always mean. So that is T was T mean. Whereas design is to be made 20% more than the mean value. It means that whatever the torque you calculate from power equation is to be multiplied by 1.2 times. And then that value is used to calculate the shear stress. Is that correct? So di by do, that equals to k, is 3/8, power is 600 kilowatts, n is 110, the td equal to 1.2, tau equal to 63, l equal to 3 meter, theta is 1.4 in degree, 0.0244 radian, and g is equals to 84, 10 to the power 3. Using the formula of power, first of all we'll calculate mean torque. So this is 600, 10 to the power 3 is 2 pi 110 divided by 60 mean torque. So mean torque will come out to be 520.87, and hence we can calculate the design torque, which is 1.2 times of mean torque, that equal to 62504 newton meter. Question is, we can calculate torque, design torque is given. So design torque is equal to pi by 16 times do cube into 1 minus k to the power 4 multiplied by tau. So design torque is 62504 10 to the power 3 newton mm pi by 16 do cube, we don't know, 1 minus k is 3/8 to the power 4 and tau is 63. So outer diameter will come out to be 172. We have given the another constraint, that is theta is given, L is given. So we have the equation T by J, that is design torque divided by J multiplied by G theta by L. Design torque is 62504. Divided by pi by 32. Do to the power 4 I will take out common. So is it 1 minus k to the power 4? Correct? Because what is j? Pi by 32, do to the power 4 minus di to the power 4. So do is taken common. So 1 minus di to the power 4 by do to the power 4 is equals to, the g is given as 84. 10 to the power 3, theta is 0.0244, and the value of L is given as 3 meter, that is 3000 mm. So if you solve this, your answer for DO will be 175.
So we have used the two constraint. One constraint gives the answer of 172.7. Other constraint gives the answer of 175. So it is always better to use the maximum size. So design diameter DO will be 175.5. If you use 175.5, your shear stress will be lower than the permissible value of 63 megapascal. And similarly, we can calculate DI also. 65.8. The maximum normal stress and maximum shear stress analyzed for a shaft of 150 mm diameter under a combined bending and torsion were found to be 120 and 80. Is it a max value? Combined bola hai? If say combined, it's a max value. So this is maximum value of sigma max, this is tau max. Find the bending moment and the torque to which the shaft is subjected. If the maximum shear stress is limited to 100, find how much the torque can be increased if the bending moment is kept constant. So we already developed the equation for T and ME. So we have tau max. So tau max equal to 16 times T equivalent upon pi d cube. So tau max equals to 16 times under root of T square plus M square divided by pi d cube. Tau max is given as 80. 16 divided by pi d cube is 150 cube. Under root of T square plus M square . So if you solve this equation, you will get under root of T square plus M square approximately equals to 0.053. Obtain the value of under root of T square plus M square equal to 0.053, 10 to the power 9. And now we'll use the concept of sigma max. So in the combined bending and torsion, sigma max is given by 32 times M equivalent upon pi d cube. And sigma max is given as 120, 32 upon pi, d cube is 150 cube into 1 by 2. We don't know the value of m, but we know very well the value of under root of t square plus m square is 0.053, 10 to the power 9. So we got m equals to 26.5 kilonewton meter. Put this value back into this equation and solve for t. And check this value as 45.9 kilonewton meter. As far as first part is considered, we got m equal to 26.5 and t equal to 45.9. Now what is insist is that he is not going to change the bending moment, but is the maximum shear stress he has increased to 100. Correct. So if the maximum shear stress will increase to the new value, naturally the T will increase. You want to calculate how much T will be increased in that case. For part 2, we'll write this tau dash max 16 times T equivalent dash pi d cube. Tau max is 80. What is the modified value? 100. So this is 100 equals to 16 times T equivalent divided by pi multiplied by d cube is 150 cube. So what is the new value of T equivalent? So your answer is 66.26 kilonewton meter. But this T equivalent is same as, again, under root of T square plus M square. We want to calculate modified value of T, whereas the value of M remains same. So in this equation, we'll put M equal to 26.5. So can we calculate the new value for torque? New torque that we can apply if the shear stress is 100, then 60.7. What was the initial torque? 45.9. What is new torque you applied? 60.7. So can we calculate how much the torque has been increased? So delta T will be T minus T, T prime minus T, that is 60.7 minus 45.9. So it will be 14.8 kilonewton meter. Now, we are given a long shaft and is subjected to twisting moment. So, what is the principal stress? What is the stress element? Is the stress element is a pure torsion? So, this one is the stress element. That equals to tau. And if we draw the Mohr circle for this, so the Mohr circle for this particular stress is this tau. This tau is same as this tau and same as this tau. So this equals to tau max. This is tau is same as sigma max. And what is sigma max? Is the maximum value of normal stress. And since it's a maximum value, this is same as tau, and therefore tau is equals to 16 times T divided by pi d cube. So your choice is B, not choice is A or D. A steel shaft of A of diameter D, length L, is subjected to a torque T. Another shaft B made of aluminium of the same diameter D and length 0.5L is also subjected to the same torque. The shear modulus of steel is 2.5 and the shear modulus of aluminium. We want the shear stress in the steel shaft is 100. We want to calculate the shear stress in aluminium. This is just a comparison of two shafts. If we take a diameter of first shaft as D, length is L, E1 equals to E and torque equal to T. The aluminium shaft has a diameter same as D. The length for this one is 0.5 times L. Is the egg modulus for this one is E divided by 2.5, and T2 is same as T. It's a shear modulus, so this is G1, G2. Tau equals to 16 times T divided by pi d cube. Correct? There is no role of length, no role of G, because theta is not given. So we have to just compute the value of tau 1 and tau 2. So tau 1 by tau 2 is same as 1, because T is same, D is same for both cases. So that finished the answer. So tau 1 is same as tau 2 is equals to 100 megapascal. Theta is not given. That is why we are not comparing the second equation, that is G theta by L. In the first case, the shear stress is tau 1 and second case is tau 2. So we have a torque equals to, or tau equals to 16 times T by pi d cube. Since the T is same, so T tau multiplied by D is constant, or tau 1 D1 is same as tau 2 D2, or tau 1 r1 is same as tau 2 r2 this is q so this one is also q so what is the final answer so tau 1 by tau 2 is 2 q that equals to 8 1 by 8